Dear learners, welcome to EPG Paathshala. I am Munish Ahlawat from Institute of Hotel Management, Dehradun. Today, we shall be taking module number 36, titled Ice Creams and Frozen Desserts, under paper Food Production Operations and Management. The learning objectives of this module are: know what are ice creams and sherbets and their ingredients, to know about different types of ice creams, to know how to judge the quality of ice cream, know the methods of preparation and freezing of sherbets and ice creams, to know about frozen desserts. Frozen dessert. Ice is a general term used in culinary preparation to identify the group of frozen desserts that include sherbets and ice creams. Sherbet. Sherbet is an American word derived from the French sorbet. The basic mixture for all sherbets is the combination of sugar syrup and fruit juice or fruit juice alone. It is a lower fat content and higher acidity level that distinguishes the sherbet from ice creams. Commercially produced sherbets also contain milk solids, but not milk fat. Sherbets, also known as sorbet and granites, make a suitable light dessert, although they are used mostly as a refresher in formal dinner. Sherbet types. Granite. Granite, also termed as granita and ice, is the simplest form of sherbet. It is made with fruit juice, champagne or wine with very little sugar added. It has somewhat tart but highly refreshing taste. The low sugar content as well as the freezing method, frozen without agitation, allows the formation of large ice crystals. Sherbet. Sorbet. Sorbets are based on fruit juices, as in the granite or in some cases fruit purees. The refined texture of sorbet is product of the egg whites, a component in most recipes. Egg whites inhibit the formation of very large ice crystals. On occasion, an element of cream may be added to the sorbet mixture. This creates a variation in texture and flavor. The addition of cream also adds fat to the product. Spume. Spuma. Spume differs from sherbets primarily in the amount of egg whites in the mixture. A spume contains approximately twice the egg whites found in sorbet. Also, the egg whites in the form of meringue are usually folded in after the mixture has been partially frozen. This yields a very light, refreshing and always soft consistency, although they can be made with fruit juices. Spume are most often made using a wine such as champagne, Sauternes or Muscat. Punches. Punches are sorbets made using a dry white wine and citrus juice. Rum or a similar mixture is mixed just prior to the service. About other frozen desserts. In addition to the ice creams and sorbets, other popular frozen creations include classical parfaits, frozen soufflés, soufflés, glaces, frozen mousses, and desserts composed of several items such as coupe and bombs. All of these have at least one thing in common. They must be served immediately once they are plated. Soufflé glaces. Frozen soufflés fold Italian meringue into a parfait or bomb mixture flavored with liqueur or fruit to give the dish a hint of lightness found in a hot soufflé. The filling is then piled high above the rim of a souffle, mold and served frozen still in the form. Coupes. Coupes are popular and practical individual ice cream or sorbet servings, decorated with liqueurs, sauces, fruits, nuts, and or whipped cream. Some coupes are elaborated, decorated with cookies and marzipan or chocolate fingers. Others are plain and simple. Coupes always must be assembled and decorated to order. Ice creams. Technically, ice cream may be defined as the partly frozen form with an air content of 40 to 50% air by volume. The continuous phase of the form contains dissolved and colloidal solids such as sugars, proteins, and stabilizers. The fatty phase is in the emulsified form. Some of the milk proteins are structurally related to the fat globules of the emulsion. Limitation. Imitation ice cream is known as Mallorine and is made now in many parts of the world. Mallorine is cheaper than ice cream because in expensive vegetable, fats and oils are substituted for the more expensive dairy fats. Other than this, Mallorine has almost the same composition as ice cream. There is still no cheap substitute for milk protein. Although some vegetable proteins, particularly from soya bean with improved flavors, are used to prepare lactose-free ice creams. Prevention of Food Adulteration Act, PFA, Rule A, 11 February 2008, defines ice cream and kulfi as under the frozen food obtained from cow or buffalo milk or a combination thereof, or from a cream or milk product with or without the addition of cane sugar, dextrose, liquid glucose, and dry liquid glucose, eggs, fruits, and fruit juices, preserved fruits, nuts, chocolate, edible flavors, and permitted food colors. It may contain permitted stabilizers and emulsifiers not exceeding 5% by weight. The mixture should be suitably heated before freezing. The product must contain not less than 10% milk fat, not less than 36% total solids. Except when the aforesaid preparation contains fruits, nuts, or both. The content of the milk fat shall not be less than 8% by weight. Starch may be added to a maximum extent of 5% under the declaration of the label. The standards of ice cream shall also be applied to softy. Ice cream is a complex system in which the stable mixed emulsion of four-phase system of fat, water, ice, air must be balanced and protected from breaking and separating. The blend of milk fat and non-fat solids with sugar must result in a product of pleasing taste and one which is smooth and creamy. Composition of the mix is important because the most critical stage of ice cream manufacture is the mechanical blending, freezing and hardening of the ice cream. Ice creams, by nature of their mixture, are richer than sherbets. This is due to the presence of fat in the basic mixture. The FDA requires that any product sold as ice cream must contain a minimum of 10% milk fat, butter fat. The outstanding factor that distinguishes ice cream from sherbets is the relative richness and fine, creamy, smooth texture of the product. While sherbets are based primarily on fruit juices, ice creams are based on creams and custards that are flavored with fruit or other flavorings. In addition, ice creams and frozen custards contain saturated fats. While sherbets, if containing any fat, contain unsaturated fats. Ice cream types. Regular ice cream. Regular ice cream is churned during freezing. The churning of ice cream as it freezes is one of the reasons it develops a smooth, creamy texture. As the mixture freezes, the constant mixing action keeps the forming ice crystal small. Sundaes are desserts made with one or more scoops of different flavored regular ice creams and are accompanied by a sauce. They can be garnished with a wide variety of fruits, candies, and nuts. Other desserts made with regular ice cream include baked Alaska and profit rolls. Lightened ice cream. Lightened ice cream is still frozen ice cream. Still frozen means that the mixture is not churned during freezing. Bomb. Bomb ice bomb is potentially the most dramatic of frozen desserts. Different flavors of lightened ice cream are lured into the bomb. The mold is often in the shape of a hemisphere. When completed, the bomb is turned out of the mold and decorated with whipped cream. Small meringues, wafer, cookies or chocolate. Parfait and frozen soufflés. The soufflé mixture is most often based on whipped egg yolk and sugar syrup foundation that is flavored and then lightened with whipped cream. In Europe, parfaits are molded in oblong or rectangular terrine molds and are sliced and served accompanied by a sauce and garnish. In America, parfaits are often served as lightened or regular ice cream in tall, narrow glasses, layered with various fruits, sauces or liqueurs and topped with whipped cream. Frozen souffles are filled in molds to which a band of paper is wrapped around the rim to allow the mold to be filled up to its top. When the paper is removed, the frozen souffle resembles its hot counterpart. Frozen mousse. This can be made from either a creme anglaise base or from a syrup. The mixtures are whipped to a frothy state after being assembled. It is then still frozen. Basic ingredients. Cream. Whipping cream with its natural creamy taste makes the best ice cream, especially when mixed with strong, rich flavors such as coffee, toffee or chocolate. Double cream is, however, a must for vanilla or brown bread ice cream. Clotted cream and creme fraiche, the thick, rich, lightly soured French style cream, make delicious additions to fruit, honey and spice ice creams. Milk. There are wide varieties of milks available in market. Skimmed milk should be avoided when making ice cream due to its low fat content and thin taste. Yogurt. Generally, plain yogurt is used for its creamy and smooth texture. Sometimes stronger and sharper sheep and goat milk yogurt is also used. Cheeses. Fat-free fromage frais is added to fruit or vanilla ice creams. Ricotta, an Italian whey cheese, has a white, creamy, soft texture and is used in certain ice creams. Mascarpone, Another Italian cheese has a deep buttery yellow color and similar to that of cream cheese. For the best results, mix mascarpone with fromage frais for a rich tasting fat reduced dessert. Non-dairy products. Soya milk, either sweetened or unsweetened, and coconut milk is used. Sweeteners, castor, superfine sugar has been used in most of the recipes, components and their contribution. There are variety of components that come together to make the sun of what we think of as ice cream, to make the sum of what we think as ice cream or sherbet. The part that each component plays in the mixture is integral to the final product. Boiling sugar. Not all ice creams and sherbets are based on sugar syrups. Those based on sugar generally use the granulated type. Egg. In most ice creams, whole eggs or egg yolks can be found in the custard. This inhibits the formation of large ice crystals during the freezing process and results in a smoother, more richly textured product. Whipped egg whites, when mixed into ice cream prior to freezing, helps to hold air in the mix, allowing a light and airy product. Sherbets sometimes contain whipped egg whites, which inhibits the formation of large ice crystals. Milk cream. These contribute to richness and flavor of the mixture. It also assists in development of a smooth texture. Fruits. They are the main source of flavoring for the ice creams and sherbets and can be used in wide variety of forms, such as purees, juices, or pieces of whole fruits. Nuts. They contribute to the flavor and texture of the ice creams. Ground praline is used as flavoring mixed into the ice cream base or as a garnish sprinkle onto the completed ice cream. Nut butters are a major constituent of ice cream. Bases for some ice cream. Spices and flavoring. Spices can be added in the form of powders such as cinnamon and nutmeg, or an infused liquid can be added where the flavoring agent is steeped in a liquid that is boiling hot. Or a decoction can be used where the flavoring agent is boiled or simmered in a liquid. Purees are also used as flavorings. Sweeteners, sucrose, cane sugar or beet sugar is the typical sweetener used in ice creams. But maple syrup, molasses and honey are also common when substituting honey for granulated sugar in ice cream custard. The amount should be reduced about 20%. Keep in mind also that once it has been frozen, the ice cream will not taste as sweet, as freezing dulls the intensity of the sweet flavor. Even though the sugar content of the total solids in the custard is typically close to 15%, particularly, flavors will require sweeter custards than others. With a relatively high portion of sugar can be beneficial in keeping an ice cream smooth and pliable after freezing. Too much sugar can prevent the ice cream from becoming firm enough to use. Stabilizers. Stabilizers are used to increase emulsification, prevent separation, improving body texture and retard or reduce ice crystals in storage by binding water, and increase resistance to melting. Stabilizers are more important in sorbet and sherbets than in ice creams, because sorbets and sherbets have less total solids than ice cream mixtures. A stabilizer will affect body syrup drainage and overrun in the finished product. Types of stabilizers. Eggs. Eggs act as a stabilizer in ice creams. For the most part, egg yolks are used rather than the whole eggs. Gums. Gum, karaya, oat gum, guar seed gum, gum acacia, India gum, tragacanth, and cellulose gum are used as stabilizers. Carrageen, salt of carrageen, a vegetable stabilizer also known as iris moss, is seaweed found growing off the coast of Ireland. CMC, sodium carboxymethyl cellulose, widely used by commercial ice cream makers. It has the qualities of both a stabilizer and an emulsifier. It does not set as firmly as gelatin. Lecithin, a fatty substance found in egg yolks. Gelatin. Gelatin has the ability to gel the mixture at various temperatures and stages of production. It is better suited to ice creams than sherbets or sorbets because it tends to produce an increased overrun in the latter. Agar agar, an expensive vegetable stabilizer extracted from red algae seaweed found off the Pacific coast, generally used in combination with the gums and or gelatin. Ice cream quality. Quality implies a clearly produced ice cream of acceptable flavor, taste, body and texture. The composition of the product and the ingredients used should be within the parameters and the limits set by the food laws. The desirable physical properties of ice cream should be defined mainly in terms of the texture as it is eaten. The consistency should be smooth and creamy, and the air content should be finely distributed. There should be a quick melting effect on the palate without greasiness or gumminess and with no gritty ice sensation. As the ice cream warms up, it should have a tendency to retain its shape, and as it melts, a creamy and not a watery serum should be removed. Flavor acceptability is governed by the quality of the ingredients that are used as well. Fruits, nuts, chocolate, as well as the added flavors should be of a good quality. However, the basic flavor must come from high quality of milk and cream. Composition of ice cream. Ice cream is composed of milk products, sweeteners, eggs, flavorings, and stabilizers or emulsifiers. The US Food and Drug Administration, FDA, requires that commercial products labeled ice cream must contain not less than 10% milk fat, butter fat, and must have at least 20% MSNF, milk solid, no fat. A good quality ice cream should have a minimum of 40% total solids, fat, sweetener, and MSNF. Milk solids contribute to the whipping capability of the custard. However, if the custard contains too large a percentage of milk solids without enough fat from egg yolks to balance, the lactose or milk sugar can crystallize, making the custard feel gritty. This is known as sanding. Judging the quality of an ice cream. Ice creams are judged and rated on the following points: texture and smoothness. This is determined primarily by the size of the ice crystals and the emulsifying or whipping ability of the custard combined with amount of milk, sugar, lactose that is added, mouth feel or body. This is established by the total solids in the custard in conjugation with the overrun, which is the amount of air incorporated while freezing. Richness and flavor. These factors are produced from the composition of the custard. The fat and MSNF contained in a premium ice cream should come from the mixture of whole milk and cream. Evaporated, condensed or dry milk should not be used, as these products adversely affect the fresh taste of the finished ice cream. Preparations of ice creams and sherbets. Basic mixture preparation. For basic preparation, there are three primary components. Sugar syrup is the predominant ingredient in a sherbet base. The basic mixture for sugar syrup is sugar, water, basic custard. 1:1 sugar:water, 2 basic custard constitutes the predominant portion of most of the ice cream bases. The basic mixture is 1 liter milk plus 10 eggs plus 200 grams sugar. Meringues are prepared for ice creams and sherbets. Egg whites are whisked in a grease-free bowl until soft peaks form. Castor or confectioner's sugar is then added and the whisking is continued until the stiff peaks form. Freezing. The type of equipment used affects the texture of the end product. Churning freezers. Ice-cooled freezers can be hand-cranked or electric and are cooled by ice and rock salt. Self-contained coolant type freezers have a double-walled bowl which is filled with a super coolant. The bowl is placed in the freezers hours prior to use. Fully electric churning freezers are both churned and cooled by electricity. Non-churning equipment. The stir freezing method is for the production of more coarsely textured granites and ices. All that is needed is a standard freezer, a metal mixing bowl and a whisk. The blender or food processor method is where a portion of the sherbet base is frozen in ice cube trays. The frozen cubes are then placed in a blender with the unfrozen base. The mixture is blended until a smooth, icy mixture is obtained. The technique used for freezing will be decided by the type of product that is desired. Sherbet requires constant churning during the freezing process. Granite can be partially still frozen in metal bowl. Spume is frozen in the same manner as sherbet. However, it is frozen slightly firmer than that desired for a sherbet. Regular ice cream is made by churning the mixture constantly during freezing. Lightened ice cream is still frozen after the mixture is aerated with the whipped cream or meringue. Bomb, parfait and frozen souffle mixtures are all still frozen. Available forms, ice cream is available frozen, pre-packaged in a wide variety of sizes. It is also available in form to which it is added and then the mixture is churned. Frozen. Premium brands contains 12-15% milk butter fat. This gives products a rich, dense, smooth sensation when eaten. Overrun is another factor in the quality of ice cream. It is the amount of air incorporated into the mix during freezing. Lower the overrun, denser and richer the product. Ice creams with high overrun feel warmer on the tongue. Smoothness is another important quality indicator. There should be a completely smooth feel to the ice cream, excluding the incorporation of nuts, fruits, and other forms of garnish. There should also be no evidence of tiny ice crystals or refreezing, handling and storage. Proper service of ice creams and sherbets requires that molded ice creams and sherbets be allowed to soften slightly after demolding. This is best done by placing the product in the refrigerator, an average of 30 minutes before service. Sherbets and ice creams are good for only 20 minutes after they are removed from the refrigerator. They should be stored in tightly sealed tall containers and need to be stored at minus 18 degrees centigrade. The maximum storage time for ice cream is 3 weeks and for sherbets and parfaits 2 weeks. Dear students, let's summarize. Now we have learnt what are ice creams and sherbets and the role of ingredients used in their preparations. We have also discussed different types of ice creams and different frozen desserts. We have also discussed the role of components and their contribution in ice cream and sherbet preparations. Thank you.